story involves a young patient who was born and had the signs and symptoms of a very serious muscular disorder called spinal muscular atrophy. And spinal muscular atrophy is a very serious neuromuscular disorder wherein the patients slowly lose control of all of their muscles. And over time, they essentially lose the ability to even expand their rib cage. And it can be fatal within a year or two of birth. The reason I got involved is that we do test utilization review, and it came up on our list as a miscellaneous test order. One of the things we have that at my institution is we have really great communication between the laboratory and the genetic counselors and medical genetics. And the reason why that is that we have a medical geneticist and a genetic counselor who work part-time in our department. And the geneticist and the genetic counselor have an extensive background in seeing patients with spinal muscular atrophy, and they know the consequences of this disease. We sent off the sample, and usually that's where my involvement would end. But what happened in this particular case was that at night, a lot of times I'll read science stories, and I happened to come across an article that was talking about this new treatment for spinal muscular atrophy. And what was really astounding about this article was that they said that they ended this trial early because of the kids who were getting this new treatment for spinal muscular atrophy were doing so much better than the kids who were getting placebo that they felt it was unethical to continue. Now, knowing that the genetic counselor that I work with had a lot of background in treating or diagnosing kids with spinal muscular atrophy, I immediately sent her this story. She was floored because for many years she saw these patients get spinal muscular atrophy and die. So she got in contact with the ordering clinician. Unfortunately, because the study had ended, they couldn't get this patient into the trial. But because the study had ended, this was now an approved treatment. This kid was one of the first kids to get this treatment in an approved manner. And we don't normally in the laboratory get a lot of follow-up. We don't know how patients are doing. But because of our involvement, I can say that because of knowing the people involved in it, the child was doing much better after even just the first treatment and had recovered a lot of their functions that they'd already lost. But it was just one of those moments where because we communicate and we work together and we know each other's roles, we are able to affect this child's outcome. My name is Dr. Mark Cervinsky, and I'm an associate professor of pathology and laboratory medicine at the Geisel School of Medicine at Dartmouth and the director of clinical chemistry at Dartmouth Hitchcock Medical Center in Lebanon, New Hampshire.